Hello there, I'm Gav.
I'm Dan.
We're the Slow Mo Guys, and we're here in the Nevada desert. You know, as you do, you just stand in the desert, don't you?
Nothing here, so
nothing going on.
Great place to fire guns.
Great place to fire guns. Guns and slow mo, always great. Big thanks to EA for sponsoring this video. We're here to promote Battlefield 1. Dan, what do you like about the First World War, the Great War?
It's the amount of tech that was made. As a kid, I never understood how they managed to do the thing where they fired machine guns through the propellers of planes. I just didn't understand it.
The old sync gear.
Yeah, and now I'm a grown-up and I've sort of, you know, the internet has been invented. I've been able to look it up. And they had something called sync gear, like you said, where the bullets managed to just go in between the propellers and so they could fly the plane and shoot where they're looking at, as opposed to trying to control a gun and a plane at the same time, which I imagine is really hard.
Well, it's very difficult to find a World War I plane that still shoots live ammo through its own propeller. But thankfully, we've been able to recreate exactly that with this device, and we're going to film it at extremely high speeds.
Yeah, I whipped this up last night. I can't wait to get on it.
You made this, did you?
Yeah, I made it with a hammer, screwdriver, spanner.
Phillips head?
Yeah, Phillips head.
And a number two monkey wrench.
Number three, actually.
Number three.
Yeah.
All right. Well, let's take a look at this thing.
Yeah. I'm in.
That's a funny sight.
I think I'm too short for this thing. Were they taller in World War One or something?
Well, I don't think they're on tiptoes.
I can't imagine
like
this being the most comfortable thing in the world.
But Fred Flintstone through the bottom left.
Hey, it was World War One. I don't know these things. They might have done.
Yeah. What gun is this then?
Oh, so this is a Vickers machine gun from World War One. Authentic stuff. I mean, in actual fact, we couldn't get hold of one of those. So we turned an M60 upside down and stuck one of these bad boys on it and the heatsink to make it look cool, which it does. I'm happy with it.
I like the sound of an M60. Well, I've only shot them in video games, but it's always like dug,
dug, dug, dug. It is meaty, isn't it?
Some majestic looking footage.
Oh, I love how it's so close to the propeller. The bullets going past it, like here.
It's like, how last minute can we fire the bullets? Like, ooh, eeks right by.
Oh man.
And it's amazing when we're on the 2511 at 120,000 FPS, it pretty much just pauses the propeller.
Yeah, this is moving fast, right?
Yeah.
So the neural eye is moving rapidly, but the bullet is just moving on an order of magnitude that's just way faster.
Yeah, so this is like hovering in the air and that's like, pshoom!
Yeah, look, we could have just stopped this, to be honest. Just be like, yeah, bang, sweet, shot done.
You know what though?
What?
I'm pretty sure 90% of the audience watching this are thinking,
I know what you're thinking.
Well, what happens if it hits, right?
Yeah. So we could desync, we could turn off the sync gear.
Yeah.
So that instead of just shooting at the right time, we just unload with the machine gun completely. And hopefully, by chance, we'll get it hitting through the propeller, just trashing it.
Just sort of like, go for it, see what happens, see you later.
Oh man, imagine landing, like, successful mission, and you're just like, oh, man.
You just park up like, another job.
Yeah. All right, well, let's desync it.
Let's desync the sync gear.
Yeah, let's do it. Flipping heck. So we took off the sync gear and looks like we got four hits.
Yeah, one. Judging by the high speed, one went straight through the hole that was already made by a previous one.
So it's one, two, three, and then a little nick there, and it's four.
Oh, flip.
Ooh, I could fry an egg.
Yeah, flipping hot. Well, we learned that if you keep your propeller at around 200 RPM, it can survive a couple of bullets through it.
Yeah, I mean, normally when you're flying one of these things, they go around at 1,200 RPM.
Well, we couldn't.
Which means
we had to tone it down a little.
Yeah, well, if we had it going at that speed on the ground, it would just start juddering along the floor and taking off.
Hard to focus on a moving plane.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, hopefully you enjoyed that video. I certainly did. I found it very interesting. Feel free to follow us on Twitter, buy a shirt. We've got a second channel. And most importantly today, make sure you check out Battlefield 1. I actually pre-downloaded it on my PC over there, so.
I have too. Should we go and play it over there?
Let's go. Yeah. In the desert.
Yeah. Yeah.